So today's top three report in the account. We had a pretty exciting day today. The number one performer in the account today was KOSS. KOSS went absolutely crazy today, and it has been on fire since I got into it just a few days ago. Today, the performance on KOSS was 608%. It's still trading actively in the overnights, so these numbers are actually changing a little bit. Overall, since I got into it, it's up over 1,600%. Now, I purchased KOSS just about 3 days ago at $3.99 a share. I got 250 shares, and today it shot all the way up to, where is this? $89, $90 in that range in the overnight trading. It is still trading heavily right now. And currently in the open position, I have $15,000 worth of profit. I did sell 20% of my position today in order to lock up some profits. So at this point, KOSS is a free trade. It doesn't matter what happens with it. I'm going to be profitable with it. I've pulled out my initial investment. Normally, I like to stay with a position and just move my stop loss up behind it. But when the market gives you a gift like this, it kind of makes sense to take a little bit of it off the table. And so that's what I did. My second number one performing trade for the day was GameStop. Now, GameStop apparently is in the middle of a short squeeze, and maybe KOSS is too. I don't know. There's really no news about KOSS. GameStop, everyone seems to believe, is a short squeeze. But I didn't buy it because of that. The reason I bought GameStop, and I don't understand why anyone would be short this stock. I mean, the person who was behind the decision to short 50% of the float of GameStop ought to have their head examined. I mean, their investors got to be livid about the poor decision making. Put in its bottom in 2019. And anybody who has any experience trading stocks at all would have seen that. And then we get a nice little rally, fall back down a little bit, followed by a base that went completely through the year of 2020. Maybe if you were short before 2020, okay, I could see that. But being short this stock through 2020, absolutely need to have your head examined. Anybody would have known not to have done this. It's certainly someone who's supposedly knows enough about the markets that they would be running a hedge fund or something. I mean, it's just embarrassing that they would be short this. Here's a nice long base. Bases happen when stocks are bottoming. So when you see a base, the stock is probably bottoming. This particular base happens to be accumulation, which is a good indication that the stock is about to start moving up. Anyway, we have not had a new low in this stock since last April. Since last April, the stock has been consistently going up, and that's a sign that, well, it's going to keep going up. Here we have another base. Stock is smiling at you. Another base. The stock is still smiling at you. You have volume spikes on each end of this base. This one here would actually justify a long position. I didn't trade the stock right here, but you could have. And if you would have, it probably would have worked out well for you. Then we get into another higher base period here. Again, the volume is smiling at you. You have peaks on both ends of this base, and that's what we like to see. Now, let's zoom in to where actually I got into the stock. Now, I trade mostly volume and price action put together, and if I see a long base, again, the stock's smiling at you twice there, then that's something I like to trade. And I just took a little bite of this. I think I originally had 14 shares or something like that. I don't know. You can go back and check another video. And I bought it right in here. We have this nice long base followed by a rally with a consolidation. That's what I like to buy. That's what makes sense to me. And of course, you know, following 4 days later, we go from $41 a share to $300 a share. That doesn't always happen, but it happens a lot when you know what you're doing. Anyway, GameStop today was up 110%. And since I first got into it, as of the overnight trading right now, it's up over 600% for me. So that's a pretty good winner. Today's activity was pretty volatile, at least in the stocks I trade. I got stopped out of a lot of stuff today, probably 10 positions I closed. Some were automatic stops, and other ones were just I looked at the charts, changed my mind, and closed the position. It's highly likely that who's ever getting squeezed on GameStop has to go in and close out other positions in order to meet their margin calls. So that's probably affecting some of my other positions, but it doesn't matter. If stock goes down, I sell it. If the stock goes up, I buy it. That's it. I don't care about what's going on. I don't care about the news. I don't even track the news. In fact, I had no idea that GameStop was even shorted by 50% because I don't care. I don't care what other traders do. What I care is how the stock looks to me. And to me, a rising stock with decent volume and a long-term base, that's a buy. So I bought it. My other top performer for the day is Jan 1. That is J-A-N. And this one, I believe I bought, actually, I think I bought it yesterday. But today, as of right now, it's up 177%. Overall on the trade, I'm up 199%. And again, the way I trade, I take small bites of a lot of different stocks. I have over 69 positions right now open in my account. Earlier in the day when the market opened, I had about 80 or so. But again, I closed out a lot of positions today because things were looking weak and things got automatically stopped out. And that's how I trade. Anyway, this Jan 1, let's take a look at the chart here. What's going on here is we have a base that more or less began in September, October of last year. And then this stock put in a base for 5 months. We have a nice smile on the chart. We have high volume going into the base. We have high volume coming out of the base and low volume in the middle. This is exactly the kind of pattern I like to see. When I see this, I jump on it. And typically, this pattern has a tendency to give you these nice moves. Anyway, you place your trades, you place your stop loss, and you get out. Now, this is my TC2000 account. And as you can see over here, this is more or less all the positions I have. And today was more or less a red day. It looks like I'm being clobbered all across the board today. But you know what? That's the way the game is. Sometimes you make money, sometimes you lose money. Overall, here, let's click this. Overall, if you pay attention to this green, most of the positions I have are actually profitable by a small amount overall, probably 2/3. And, you know, you can't get upset that some stocks are losing money and some stocks are making money. If you trade the market right, it doesn't really matter. Stay with your winners, close out your losers, never be afraid to close out a losing trade. If you want to make money over the long term, you have to get rid of trades that are not working out. And the quicker you do it, the better off you will be. Stay trading.